Listeners, how's it going? It has been such a long time. I've missed you guys so freaking much. So this video is gonna be a part of a couple other videos. I don't know how many yet because I haven't shot those videos yet. It's going to be talking about the process of interior design. We're gonna be talking in details, questions that are asked. I'm trying to create a series that could have helped me in the beginning of my career in interior design. We're gonna be starting with the first initial stage of interior design is getting the client. This is the most important thing because if you don't have any clients, then how do you design anything, you know? How do you get that bread? You know what I mean? Let me segue through this. Thank you so much for supporting this channel. If you haven't subscribed already, please help yourself to the subscribe button. It's free. Thank you very much. These are the most important four ways on how you get the interior design client, especially if you're just starting out on the freelancing airway. Before you get that client, what you need to know is that you need to have a portfolio. So sometimes you do need to give a little bit of work or free work or a consultation in interior design just so that you can collect some work. If you worked with a company before, ask that company what their policy about you sharing your work with them as a part of your portfolio. A lot of the companies don't have a problem with that, and some companies they give you trouble, legal trouble or whatever. So basically all you need to know is only include the work that you're proud of. And I have a whole video about how to make a portfolio in PowerPoint, which is like the easiest software ever. So you can check that here. That's another segue. Let's segue out of it. You need to know the dynamics of your target client before you start targeting your client. Does that make sense? A lot of people nowadays use Instagram. Hey Siri, how many people use Instagram daily?
Okay, I found this on the web for how many people use Instagram daily.
Okay, I'll tell you how many people use Instagram per month. That's 1.1 billion people use Instagram monthly. Your clients can be one of those 1.1 billion people. There's a lot of ways to improve your Instagram, but make sure that you have a little bit of work on your Instagram, that your bio says that you're an interior designer, and that you have your clear call to action that you do interior design. So I'm saying that you can use social media, which is something that's free, to your advantage. I would say to step it up a little bit more and do a promotion every month. Even if you spend like as little as $1 per month on Instagram ads, one of those people might be seeing your ad and trying to connect with you. And another professional tip, build a relationship with people who are potential clients. I'll tell you that my fourth client ever was from Instagram, and we connected there, and it went very well, and it was such a good project to work on. So Instagram is a very, very great way. So you might ask yourself, how did you get your first client? Well, this takes me to the second way you can get an interior design client as an interior designer or as a freelancer. This is such an obvious way, but people totally ignore it or they feel ashamed by it. I'm here to tell you that you shouldn't be ashamed to ask for work. Here's how you ask for work. You have to tell your family members and your friends that you're doing this, especially if your friends are interior designers too, because sometimes they get a project while they have a project and then they can actually give it to you. But you might say that, how would someone give me a project that is initially theirs? Or how can I get my family members to remember that I do this for a living? Well, you have to ask yourself, what's in it for them? Now, initially, it's nothing, right? Wrong. This is why, if you've already done this and you're not getting the results, I'm telling you, you have to understand that you need to give something back. So you give that back by having a commission. And it can be 5% of the total project that they give you, it can be 10%, but I guarantee you that this way, actually, because they're just referring you and it's not taking anything of their energy, and they have this person who need your services and they're just connecting you two together. Commissions work very, very well. This method guarantees you that these people will remember you the next time. Now, it might be a little hard for you to do so because you're thinking that you are starting out and this 10% could really help you. But I'm telling you that this is how you bring more people into the table. So you can have the fourth type of clients that I'm going to be talking about later on. The third technique is actually a little bit more complex than the previous technique, and that is calling real estate agents. Now, if you have a real estate company that you know about, you can go to them and you can also do the same thing where you tell them that if they bring you people who are looking to design their houses or their offices, depending on the real estate agent that you're dealing with, they can actually bring you clients. The commission is also there. Don't worry, you put in the money to get money back. And eventually you're gonna build a base of client, which is really big. You wouldn't need referrals anymore, which is like the aim for any designer. I think I was out of focus, sorry guys. Now the fourth way, and this is my favorite way of getting clients, is the word of mouth. Someone you are working with right now or you are going to be working with will tell someone else that they hired an interior designer to do their house, their office. And if they're really happy with your work, what you might end up doing is that getting their cousin, their brother-in-law, their, I don't know, grandfather to call you. So it's such a great connection, because it means that you are good enough for people to recommend you, which is something that you want to aim for and you want to remember in your projects. I'm not saying that it went great for me in every project. I'll tell you that I've messed up in one of my projects very badly, and it's not that I messed up, it's that I didn't know how to handle certain situations, and that is a mess up. So yeah, I initially did mess up. And I'll tell you more about it later on when I'm talking about each and every point that you need to know about when you're freelancing or you're opening your own interior design practice. At the end of every video, a link down below, a podcast that I listen to. It's called Business of Design. It's by Kimberly Seldon. She is crazy good. I cannot tell you how incredible and how much I've learned from her. She talks about all kind of interior design, business related topics. I'll link one of her podcast's episode down below, and it's about clients. I'll find the most suitable one to this video. And the next video we'll talk about how to charge your interior design clients. The videos after that we will talk about the process itself and how to go from A to Z. So if you do like this video, do not forget to give it a thumbs up, and if you don't like it, give it a thumbs down. That's totally fine, I'm okay with that. And tell me, if you have freelanced before, how did you get your first client? Let's all share information and learn different techniques from different people. Thank you guys so much for watching. And for those of you who have been following me for a while, I'm really sorry for not uploading. I've had such a rough patch. I can't talk about it online yet. And I don't know if I can ever talk about it. But the thing is, I am back and I'm here. And I'm so glad to be back. Thank you guys so much for watching, and have a great time of the day wherever you are in the world. Goodbye.